welcome back to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys about my high school experience. So I actually graduated from high school last Monday, May 10th, and I did a graduation vlog. And if you guys have not watched that video, what are you doing? Go watch it right now. Pause this video, go watch my graduation vlog, and then come back. I'll put the link down below in the description box and in the comment section. But today I'm going to be telling you guys about my high school experience. Basically, really just kind of what I went through as a high schooler, freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior year. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started with this video. Talking about is freshman year or ninth grade. So number one, I was not scared at all my freshman year. I don't know if you guys know the saying or the motto that ninth grade is supposed to be like the scariest year of high school or the most intimidating year of high school. For me, it was not. I feel like my ninth grade year was really calm, cool, and collected. I kind of feel like I was a little relaxed. I got used to like the kids and the teachers and really everything that was going on in the school. Now, I have told you guys before that my school system actually divided the freshmen from the other high schoolers. So we had like a whole separate school building. And it was called the Ninth Grade Honors Academy. And honestly, I wasn't scared at all my freshman year. I mean, they say that as a little motto because it's your first year of high school. You don't really know anything about high school at all. You're supposed to be scared, intimidated by the other high schoolers. I was not scared. I was not intimidated. I was not anything, okay? I was not scared at all my freshman year. So I felt like my freshman year was like very calm and cool. Number two, it was boring. My freshman year was really, really boring. I don't know what made it boring. Maybe some of the teachers. I don't really know, but honestly, it really wasn't exciting. And well, I mean, there were like a few exciting things freshman year. I think one exciting thing was actually the solar eclipse. I think it was August of 2017. I forgot the date, but I do remember it was in August of 2017. And we were actually on the campus when it happened. So that might have been like the only cool thing that really happened. But other than that, it was pretty much boring. Number three, I feel like I was really friendly in ninth grade. And I've told you guys before, I'm in a shyness shell. I won't say I'm very like afraid to talk to people, but I really just don't know how to start up a conversation. But maybe because of the fact that ninth grade was not scary, I guess I felt like I was a little bit more open to people. So I felt like I made like a lot of friends ninth grade. I was friendlier than what I already was. And I did have a lot of friends ninth grade. So I feel like I was a little bit friendlier my freshman year. Number four, I had a crazy teacher. Okay, every year, everybody has some type of crazy teacher. And freshman year, it was actually my English teacher. She was the last teacher in the last class I had of the day. And I was really thankful because if I had her like in the morning or in the middle of the day, I probably would have had like a panic attack because she was like the worst teacher freshman year. Well, outside of my algebra teacher, she was the worst teacher ever. I mean, from what I can remember, I think she said we could do our work in pencil, but when we had to take like tests and quizzes, we had to do it in pen. And I was like, what's the point in doing that? Like, what if we mess up something and we need to erase? And she was like, oh, just scratch it out and write next to it. I was like, what type of dumb rule is that supposed to be? So I did not like her at all. She was the worst teacher ever. But yeah, I mean, everybody in any year of school always has some type of crazy teacher. And last but not least, for my freshman year, number five, this is really sad, but number five, I actually lost a family member. So it was very tough. It was very emotional, because I was very close to this family member. She was actually my cousin. And she was actually 93 when she passed away. And it was right before my freshman year ended too. She passed away in April of 2018, and my freshman year ended almost like a month and a half later. And it hit me pretty hard because I knew she was gonna pass away at some point in time because of her age, but I did not think it was gonna happen as soon as it did. So it hurt me for sure. That she did pass away, because she's no longer here with me or my family. And that was really like the first death in the family I actually experienced. I did have other deaths in my family before that one, but that was the one that really just kind of hurt me and devastated me the most. But that did happen my freshman year. So yeah, so that was pretty much my experience for my freshman year. The second year I'm going to be talking about is my sophomore year, or 10th grade. So number one, the work was easy. I felt like the work sophomore year was just super easy. Like, I don't know if it was the teachers or if it was just like the environment or the atmosphere of 10th grade, but I just feel like the work 10th grade was definitely easier. It was easier than 9th grade work. But I don't know. I just felt like work for me as a sophomore was super easy. Number two, I tried out for the basketball cheer team. So I do remember telling you guys in a whole lot of previous videos, that I've always wanted to be a cheerleader. But I actually never told you guys that I tried out for the cheer team or the basketball cheer team. And obviously that was my sophomore year. And unfortunately, I did not make the team. And I felt like I actually started a little too late to be a cheerleader. I should have started sixth grade when I was in middle school. Because I didn't have enough experience as a cheerleader to even be on the team. So unfortunately, I did not make the cheer team, but at least I tried. Number three, I had a lot of friends sophomore year. I feel like sophomore year, I was friendly too, and I did tell you guys I was friendly freshman year too, but I feel like I had a lot more friends sophomore year. And again, I don't know if it was because of the atmosphere of 10th grade, or maybe just the teachers or whatever it would have been. I don't really know. But I feel like I had like a lot of friends in 10th grade. I was hanging out with them outside of school and in school. So I feel like I was a little bit friendlier in 10th grade, and I did have a lot more friends in 10th grade than I did in 9th grade. Number four. This one here is really, really messed up. But number four, my school started construction. So I also remember telling you guys that my school has been around since 1917, and it was time for reconstruction, okay? It was time for reconstruction. And unfortunately, they had to start my sophomore year of high school. So my high school, or my sophomore year, was 2018-2019, and they actually started the construction in 2018. And when I tell you guys, it was a hot mess. It was a hot mess. It was a lot of noise. It was a lot of banging. It was a lot of like holes all over the campus. It was dirt everywhere. It was some places cut off. We had to take detours. They had to move classes to other buildings and other parts of the school. It was just a mess. Okay, it was a hot mess. But when it rained, it was 10 times worse. Because when rain and dirt mix, guess what that makes? That makes mud. And it was horrible because we had to dodge mud, and then we also had to dodge not falling into a hole. So it was very chaotic when they started the construction, and the construction even continued into my junior and senior year. But to be honest, I'm not even mad that I even went through all of that. I don't regret anything about going through all of that horrible time, if you will, because it was a hot mess. But I don't regret it at all because it turned out beautiful. And I have plenty of school vlogs up on my channel. But it turned out amazing. So I'm not mad that I might have gotten some shoes muddy, or maybe some peeled off skin or whatever, because I might have fallen by accident. I actually did fall by accident maybe like twice. But I don't regret anything because the school looks absolutely amazing. And last but not least, for my sophomore year, number five, I really, really, really liked my sophomore year. And I actually had two favorite teachers sophomore year. It was my biology teacher and a teacher that taught intro to human studies. Those were my two favorite teachers. And I guess I really liked sophomore year because of my favorite teachers, because of the atmosphere, I guess, and the friends that I had, the environment, the feeling of it. I don't really know what it was, but the sophomore year, I feel like, was just easy for me. I made a lot of friends, and it was just my favorite year overall. The next year I'm going to be talking about is junior year or 11th grade. So number one, I had a hard time making friends. So I know I just told you guys I was friendly in 9th grade. I had a lot of friends in 10th grade. But I don't know what it is. I don't know if you guys experience this now. But it feels like after you complete a school year and then you're distant from those students or those kids in the summertime, and then you go back the next year, it kind of feels like you don't really know the people that you were friends with the previous year. Now, that's if you keep in touch with them in the summer. And I kind of did keep in touch with some of them during the summertime. But I don't know what it is. But I just had like a hard time making friends junior year. Because it was a lot of new people coming in junior year. And I actually tried to make friends with like new people. But it's kind of hard to because I really want to say I'm like hard to open up to. I just have a shyness shell, and I guess I'm just shy around other people. So it was kind of hard for me to make friends junior year. I did have a few friends from like the previous years, but it was kind of hard for me to make new friends. Number two, I had a glow up. So I actually got my braces off sophomore year. And I actually had my braces for 2 years and 4 months. But I got them off sophomore year. But junior year, I felt like I had a huge glow up. And what I mean by that is my skin was clearer. My hair was looking a little bit better. Obviously, my teeth were good because I didn't have my braces on anymore. And I think, I guess you could say I started dressing a little bit prettier or a little bit more girlier. And then also I started taking prettier pictures. So I felt like I had a major glow up junior year. And it's always good to have a glow up, to have a transformation going on. But yeah, so I felt like I had a huge glow up junior year. Number three, I was comfortable being by myself. So what I mean by this is I did have a few friends, but I didn't mind like having anybody around. And there was a few points in time where I actually did eat lunch by myself, but it was okay. I mean, it was fine, because some people sometimes assume if there's a kid sitting by themselves, they're like the quiet ones, they're the ones who go pop out and do something crazy in the school. To be honest, that was not me. Sometimes it's just good to stay to yourself, because you really don't need to be in the mix with a whole lot of people, because that can cause a lot of drama. So sometimes it is good to be to yourself. And honestly, I didn't mind being to myself at all junior year, really. And to be honest, I actually felt a little bit better being kind of by myself a little bit. Because obviously I'm comfortable with myself. So I was comfortable by myself a lot junior year. Number four for junior year, I lost another family member. And this family member was another cousin, another close cousin that was to me. She actually passed away in October of 2019, which was maybe about 2.5 months after I started my junior year. And yeah, that death hit me pretty hard as well. And I think really what made me like so sad and so devastated about it was because when my first cousin passed away and then my second cousin passed away, it didn't seem like it was that long before they were like both gone, because my first cousin passed away in April of 2018 and then my second cousin passed away in October of 2019. So it was a little bit over a year and a few months before my other cousin passed away. So those were really like the two main deaths that I really experienced in my lifetime. And they were really close family members, and I missed both of them a whole lot, because I didn't even actually know when my second cousin was gonna pass away, because she seemed in pretty good health to me. But unfortunately she did pass away, and that was the year when I lost another family member. And last but not least for junior year, number five, this year ended early. My junior year, which actually was my second favorite high school year, this year ended early as well because of coronavirus. Coronavirus came last year, 2020, and my junior year was definitely cut short because I had maybe like 2.5 more months of my junior year left. And I think when the pandemic first came, I think it was like 2 weeks before spring break. And then really when spring break came after that, I didn't go back to school at any time. So I really feel like my junior year was cut short, because I still had the rest of March, all of April, and almost all of May to have left at my school. But I can't do anything about what happens in the world. Nobody knew but God that coronavirus was gonna come and pretty much ruin the face of the earth. So my junior year did end early thanks to coronavirus. But that was everything for my junior year. The last year I'm gonna be talking about is my senior year, or 12th grade. So number one, I felt more independent. And I guess what I mean by this is, I mean, I should be feeling independent because I was going to be graduating in a few months, but I felt more independent. I felt like I had to do a lot of more things on my own, especially around the school. So yeah, I just feel like I felt a whole lot more independent. Number two, learning was difficult. Learning was really, really difficult because my senior year was actually 2020 to 2021. And just like I got done telling you guys in my junior year got cut short. And really the moment leading up to my senior year was really a little bit awkward because I've never been to school in a pandemic. So it was very uncomfortable. Therefore, the learning was different and difficult. I had the hybrid plan, actually, and I went to school 2 days out of the week, which was Monday, Wednesday, and then I was at home the other 3 days, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, and it was just very difficult. I mean, I've never, ever experienced a school year like that, so learning was definitely difficult, because most of all of my teachers really weren't there. And some kids had to be virtual, like 100%, but I was never virtual 100% because I do better when I learn in person. So that was really, I guess, the only way. Senior year was difficult because I had to go to school 2 days out of the week, and I had to stay at home the other three. So it was just difficult. I just feel like senior year was difficult. The learning was difficult. Everything was just different. Number three, I stayed to myself a whole lot more senior year, I feel like, than I did junior year. One, I guess because of the pandemic, I really didn't want to be close to anybody because I didn't know if they had COVID or not. And two, I really had a hard time making friends senior year. And to be honest, I was really by myself like a whole lot of time senior year. Because I really didn't want to be close to anybody, and it was really, really hard making friends or even keeping the friends I had from the previous years, because not everybody was coming to school because of the pandemic, and some were choosing to be 100% virtual. And I feel like most of my friends that I was friends with, they were like Tuesday, Thursday kids, so I didn't even get to see them in person. And to be honest, some of the kids I went to school with on Monday, Wednesday, I really didn't know them. I knew some of them, but I didn't know all of them. So that's why I feel like I stayed to myself a whole lot senior year. Number four, I didn't like any of my teachers. I won't say I hated them. I just didn't like any of my teachers at all. Because I don't know, I mean, I just didn't like any of my teachers, especially my pre-cal teacher. She was the one I disliked the most. To be honest, I really don't know why I didn't like most of my other teachers. I guess because they were just boring. And I actually did kind of like my English teacher. She was okay. But for the most part, most of my teachers were just kind of boring. They were really just giving us a lot of work. So I mean, I really just didn't like, honestly, none of my teachers, to be honest. I liked a few, but I didn't like all of them. And last but not least, for senior year, number five, I hated this year. Now, your senior year of high school is supposed to be the best year ever of high school. But for me, it was the worst because I had to live my last year of high school in a pandemic. Which obviously is something I'm not used to. So I guess just the way everything was just made up, how everything was just going, I just didn't like my senior year at all. But I am grateful for my time I had at BHS. And to be honest, even though I did not like my senior year, there were some things that I will never forget from my senior year. So I didn't like it, but it was okay. It wasn't the worst, but I honestly really did not like my senior year. So that was everything for my high school experience. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share my channel. It helped me reach my goal of 1,250 subscribers. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.